The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The Pharisees approached Jesus and asked, "Is it lawful for a husband to divorce his wife?" They were testing him. He said to them in reply, "What did Moses command you?" They replied, "Moses permitted a husband to write a bill of divorce and dismiss her." But Jesus told them, "Because of the hardness of your hearts, he wrote you this commandment. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, no human being must separate." In the house, the disciples again questioned Jesus about this. He said to them, "Whoever divorces his wife and marries another commits adultery against her. And if she divorces her husband and marries another, she commits adultery." And people were bringing children to him that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked them. When Jesus saw this, he became indignant and said to them, "Let the children come to me. Do not prevent them, for the kingdom of God belongs to such as these. Amen, I say to you, whoever does not accept the kingdom of God like a child will not enter it." Then he embraced them and blessed them, placing his hands on them. The Gospel of the Lord. A number of years ago, a book came out called Bowling Alone that lamented the fact that as a society, we are increasingly doing everything by ourselves. All those social organizations, fraternal organizations, clubs that used to glue society together have kind of fallen by the wayside. And if anything, since that book was written, things have gotten a lot more isolating. Now we have technology like iPads and iPhones and iPods and I this and I that. It's all about I. Even social media that claims to connect people oftentimes only seems to isolate and fragment society further. And this is not good. The first thing that God says to us in the Bible, in the book of Genesis, as we read today, is it's not good for them to be alone. We are made for others. We are made for community. We are made for love. As one of the church documents says, human beings only find themselves through a sincere gift of self. You don't find out who you are by remaining a solitary individual chasing your own particular dreams. You find out who you are by giving yourself away to someone else. That's been the challenge of the last year and a half, is so many people have been isolated, separated from family and community and social services, and it's difficult. We're not meant to be alone. Yesterday, I celebrated two weddings. I had a funeral in between, but two weddings. And the deacon at one of the weddings was preaching about how beautiful it is when a person gives themselves away to another, and how that other person might know all of your foibles, does know all of your foibles, all of your shortcomings, all of your insecurities. And yet that person remains faithful to you. They love you. And what a sign of God's faithful love that is. That's why Jesus talks about marriage and the unity and indissolubility of marriage today. It's so important because it's a sign. Marriage is a sacrament, a sign of God's love. When we see a couple united in love, it gives us a hint of what God's love is like. When I saw those beautiful couples getting married yesterday, I said, "Oh, I get it. That's what God's love is like. It's a beautiful thing." That union of husband and wife that is marriage, that unity is so important because out of marriage comes the family. And the family is the basic building block of society. It's the basic community that's more important than any other community. And for the church as well, the family is called the domestic church, the church at home. Families, you are so important. What we do here in the church, we have faith formation after Mass today. This is all so important. But in a way, we can't really do too much other than support you, what you do at home. Children grow up learning what it means to have faith, learning what it means to love from their own families. And so parents, no pressure, but you have the most important job in the world to bring God's love to your children. Jesus says, let the children come to me. And we're all God's children. I think he's talking about everyone there. Everyone come together as the family of God. Brothers and sisters in Christ. Jesus says, I'm not ashamed to call you brothers and sisters. We are part of the family of God. Children of the same Father. And Jesus is saying, come. All, even if you are broken, even if you are have shortcomings, even if you are messed up in your life in some ways, and who isn't? Come and let me heal you. Let me forgive you. Let me give you my mercy. We have had so many families over this past week come here to the church to mark important events, weddings and funerals, like I mentioned, baptisms, all coming to pray, Lord, bless us all the days of our life. Last Sunday, Deacon Eric gave me 4 baptisms to do at 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 12 o'clock, and 1 o'clock. And instead of saying, let the children come to me, I said, Deacon Eric, you're killing me with all these baptisms you want me to do. Fortunately, one of the families had a stomach bug, so they canceled, so I only ended up doing 3. But that's wonderful. That's life. That's the life that happens when people come together, that life that we love to see in our parish. That life, the life we love to see in our families, good times and bad, ups and downs, all the difficulties and joys of life, but God with us through it all. It's a beautiful thing. Deacon Eric does our baptism prep. He also does our wedding prep for the parish. He helps couples prepare to be that sign of God's love in marriage. I had a mother of a groom say to me recently, who does your wedding prep? Who does your pre-Cana in the parish? And I said, well, that's Deacon Eric. What did he do wrong now? And she said, my son told me he enjoyed pre-Cana. And that seemed really unusual to her because maybe they were just thinking of a program that just you have to go through, jump through the hoops. But Deacon Eric and Laura do such a wonderful job taking couples where they're at and just helping them to grow in the Lord, making it really welcoming, really accessible. And Deacon Eric is part of a wonderful staff that we have here. I feel blessed every day to work on a staff that have so many faithful and talented people. And you get to see what happens when people come together to accomplish so much more than they could on their own. And we do have a great staff here in the parish, from Stacy, who does such a great job connecting our families and helping make faith formation work for our families, help them prepare for the sacraments, to Bob, who works around here fixing the building and cleaning the church. It's a real labor of love for him, to Aaron, who just organized the Lobster Fest last Saturday. I think we had 120 lobsters sold. It was a great event. Dan and Sammy, who bring so much joy to youth ministry. Chris, who is so talented in what he does as our communication director. It's so great to work with all these wonderful people and to see what God can do when we give our best. And I'm so proud of the staff who this past year really kept things going in the parish when things were getting isolated and a lot of our volunteers had to step aside. Our staff really kept things going. And when I got here in the middle of a pandemic, things were just running very smoothly because they kept things going. But I think, and now as we come out of a pandemic eventually here in the next several months, as we come back together as community, it's so important that we start rebuilding things, that we need our volunteers to start stepping up again because our staff can't do everything. And we are blessed because of our partnership with St. Michael. We share a lot of staff. Both parishes are able to have a more robust staff than we might otherwise be able to have. But we can't do it all. We can't do it alone. We need all of you as well. We need your time and your talents and your gifts that only you have. And that's what Jesus desires for the church, for us all to come together and share those gifts and make something greater than we could ever do on our own. And so I'm not going to ask you to sign up for anything today, but I do want you to pray today and ask the Holy Spirit to help you find your place here in the church. What gift do you have to offer? Some gifts are more public, some are a little bit more hidden, but we all have gifts that we can offer, and they're all needed. And over the next few months, we're going to put a call out. We need lectors and Eucharistic ministers. We've had a challenge even scheduling those this past year because, again, people are in all different places, but we need them. And so listen for that call. We need greeters at the door to welcome people and provide that welcome to God's children that Jesus asks of us. We need people to help out with funerals during the week, with mercy meals and serving funerals and our outreach programs, our prayer line. And I'm really excited about donuts, getting started with donuts again. I have not had a donut since I've been to this parish. And starting at the end of this month, October 31st, our pastoral council has agreed to host our first coffee and donuts after the 9:30 Mass. Since COVID. So I hope you can join us, and maybe we'll get some other parish groups involved after that as well to do donuts every so often. We need that. We need to come together as community. We really miss that. And so today, I just ask that you pray and ask the Lord to reveal how you can serve, how he's calling you to serve. We all need each other, and we can accomplish so much more when we come together. We are not meant to be alone. We're not meant to bowl alone. We're meant to be that community of faith, that family of God that God created us to be. And so let's ask the Father to shower down upon us those gifts of the Holy Spirit that will empower our community to be the household of faith that he needs us to be.